Gorma good car here, look. Look, as a first Cadol Chiefs, I want to pay my tribute to all the frontline staff and all the workers in all the areas that did the children work. I want to sympathise with each and every family and the lost loved ones, and I want to thank RT Prime Time for the programme last night. It just was shocking, unforgivable what happened in the nursing homes. Minister, we're asked here today to, and I wish you well, by the way, as Minister for Health, we're asked here today to increase our budget from £18.3 billion to £20.3 billion, with very little explanation of the costs or the breakdown of costs. We're going to do it in goodwill, but it's an enormous amount of money, and we need to see value for money, and there's lots of questions have to be asked. As I said, Minister, look, things have just went, you know, they had to be done. I supported to take over the private hospitals, but I saw them costing £115 per month. I was shocked. When I saw they'd been extended to be used again for June, when there was no need, we saw there was clearly no need for them to be kept. It was just incomprehensible. And when I see the cost to City West, at 12,000 per bed, you know, out there, and four times what it costs in England, 15 million per month. It's just unbelievable money. And I just can't, 21 million in total, 115 million per month is the hospitals. Mental health, and I did get a reply to your PQ today after months of trying, Minister, about the costs. But above all, I want to, you know, say St. Michael's in Clonmel was closed down, a mental health facility, short stay, on the so-called vision for change. We have failed, in spite of numerous meetings, in spite of numerous suicides and mental health issues, to get a single bed in Tipperary, South Tipperary. Hate to see him accepted. We have a deficit of 25. And now we find that 700,000 has been spent on us to get ready for COVID, with en-suites and bathrooms. I want to salute the building contractors, or Grammar Construction, I understand, and all the builders that worked on it. They did their Trojan work. I'm not criticising them. I'm criticising the fact that we couldn't get this open for a mental health bed, and I wanted to be kept open when this is finished for a mental health bed, because we need mental health services, and the COVID crisis has made them enormous. Add on top of that, then the cervical smear, the breast check, the men's prostate, all those, the backlogs are going to be astonishing, and we seem to have money in this £2 billion today. It's just unbelievable. Minister, daily mass and the committee in effort. Minister Harris told me in the Dáil last week. He agreed with me that the churches, one size doesn't fit all. I mean, 50 in every church, it's just ridiculous. And he would be bringing it up at Cabinet. Cabinet did bring it up, there was a meeting, and I understand today that Minister Harris texted and informed other deputies that it had been changed to 100, which is a welcome step. But yet, a phone call was made from the Taoiseach's office, not the Taoiseach, to the Archbishop in Dublin last Friday night, that was changed back again. Who was pulling strings here, or what kind of reasons have they for trying to deny the people? Never did they need spiritual nourishment more than they need it now, and allow the people to go to prayer. I'm listening day in, day out in the Dáil since I joined 13 years ago, or are privileged to be elected, to the naysayers separating church and state, and now we want to control the church. Are we going back to communist Russia? That's what I see. Minister, I can't stand up here this evening on this tragic evening and such a tragic loss of life with the COVID, and we're all so concerned about it. But to read a figure that we got today from the Minister of Department of Health, 6,666 babies aborted in 2019. My God, we have COVID-19 and we have this slaughter in 2019. Is it any wonder? And where's the money coming from that? And it's become an industry, and it's a shocking indictment on our country. We're taught to be safe, legal, and rare. How rare is 6,666? It's an appalling vista on our system, that's what I say. And then we have crocodile tears about people, you know, injured and people dying in COVID. If you can compare the figures, one death anywhere is one too many. I support life from the cradle to the grave, from the womb to the tomb. And I want to say that I'm shocked. With what has just happened. It's just, it beggars belief.